On the outside, the surface of this lake looks like the aftermath of a disaster. Empty tree trunks spike out of the turquoise waters. The lake is surrounded by mountains, making it a quiet but unsettling place. But those who dare to swim under these dangerous waters will soon discover a whole new world. This isn't the beginning of a fairy tale. It's the actual story of Kayendi Lake, located in Sati, Kazakhstan. Back in 1911, an earthquake caused a major landslide in this location. The valley created eventually filled up with rainwater, practically submerging the forest. The trees that are located above the waters might look very sad, but beneath the surface, they remind you of an underwater forest. Since the waters are crystal clear most of the time, you can still see this fascinating view even from its shores. The ice-cold water makes this lake so tricky and, at times, even dangerous. And don't forget about all the algae, plants, and submerged trees that can rapidly become risky obstacles. Hey, I enjoy a steamy hot bath, but this boiling lake I'll tell you about now is really the stuff of scary dreams. It's located on the Caribbean island of Dominica, and its waters have temperatures between 180 and 197 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's just around the edges, since no one has ever dared to reach the middle of the lake to measure its core temperature. It's true that the heat can go down from time to time, but you never know when these waters may start to boil again. The place is also dangerous because of the gases it releases, such as carbon dioxide. It doesn't smell nice, trust me, but that's mostly because of the sulfur stuck in the steamy air. This seemingly calm lake also carries a dangerous surprise. Lake Manan, located in West Province, Cameroon, it's one of the few erupting lakes on the whole planet, similar to a volcano, and most of the time, it does so without any warnings. Its last eruption dates back to 1894, when it caused serious damage. The chemical mechanism of such lakes works like a can of soda that you shake before opening. There are risky gases on the bottom of the waters, so any disturbance on the surface may trigger their eruption. Natron Lake in Tanzania may be beautiful to watch because of its unique reddish coloring, but it's definitely not a place you'd want to take a swim in. While the water is extremely salty, it also combines with algae, which, by the way, are responsible for the coloring. And that's not even the riskiest thing about it. Natron Lake has pH levels so high that they become corrosive. If you dampen a piece of dyed material in this lake, it'll soon be stripped of its color. These high levels of acidity can also cause serious problems to the human skin. It's not all bad for some creatures, as Lake Natron is the only home to over 2.5 million small flamingos. These acidic and brackish waters support their survival, so it's no wonder they like to stick around. Lake Nicaragua's danger factor has less to do with chemistry and more to do with its inhabitants. It's located on the border of Costa Rica and Nicaragua and is the largest freshwater lake in Central America. When you first look at it, you won't think it can be dangerous. But because of the bull sharks inhabiting it, I wouldn't recommend taking a swim. Sharks tend to be unpredictable and at times intimidating creatures. Plus, they will eat everything if needed. Scientists initially believed this species of shark was only found in this lake. But they soon discovered that people had seen the same sharks in the Caribbean Sea. These astonishing creatures not only cross a distance of over 120 miles to get here, but can also adapt to freshwater, something not all fish can do. Belize's Great Blue Hole may seem alluring to divers. I mean, it has a gorgeous deep blue color and is pretty close to the mainland, about 62 miles. The problem is that beneath the surface of these tranquil waters is a mixed-up series of tunnels which contain many types of coral and other wildlife. These caves are what makes diving through the Great Blue Hole tricky. More so, specialists discover that deeper into the waters there are fewer and fewer creatures. Why? Because of a hidden layer of hydrogen sulfide that spans over the whole width of the sinkhole. Since there's no oxygen, no creature can ever survive this deep into the hole. Lake Lanier is the largest lake in the state of Georgia. It has a lot of visitors each year, about 11 million, so that's about the same number as visiting the Louvre Museum in Paris. Despite its popularity, a lot of accidents happen on this lake, and nobody knows for sure why. One of the explanations may lie beneath the surface of this mysterious lake. There's a lot of debris and rubble in there, along with random objects that have been tossed in, like boats, lawn chairs, and even fishing wire. All this creates a tricky underwater obstacle course. With the added low visibility on the surface of the lake, this place can become risky to navigate. Another one of those lakes that looks like someone might have overdone with editing is the Grand Prismatic Spring, located in Yellowstone National Park, which stretches into the states of Wyoming, Montana, and Idaho. Swimming here is completely prohibited. Why? It's 189 degrees Fahrenheit in the center, almost close to boiling temperatures, and the outermost ring reaches around 131, hence the colors. Since the center of the water is way too hot for any life to make it, there's nothing clouding the surface. The lack of any living organisms here creates that vivid blue that looks almost painted over. On the small Mediterranean island of Cyprus, there's not a lot of rain during the summer. That's why some bodies of water here become so dry that in certain areas, they get covered in a layer of baked salt. It's the case for the Larnaca Salt Lake. Now, don't be fooled by the eerie landscape. These lands can easily become a trap. That's because it's easy to get confused about what's actually a dry surface and what's just a thin layer of salt on top of water or mud. More so, underneath the crust are salt crystals, which can cause problems for people's skin. Sumisun Hole is one of the most dangerous places to swim in the whole of Thailand. It's because it's very deep, reaching 280 feet, and gets extremely dark. At certain points, as divers get lower, they can even reach places with zero visibility. No wonder a lot of people get confused and can't seem to find their way up anymore. The largest lake in Africa and the third largest lake in the entire world is called Lake Victoria. Not all of its waters are unsafe for people, but some regions can rapidly cause problems. Why? Particularly because it has its own isolated weather system, and that makes the weather really unreliable. It can go from bright and sunny to terrible in a matter of seconds. I mean, who would want to get caught swimming in the middle of a storm, right? Pustoyi Lake is located in Siberia, so I'm guessing I don't need to tell you the waters here get extremely cold. But if you look at the lake, there's nothing out of the ordinary with these waters. Is that completely true? Most likely not. And people tend to avoid swimming here at all costs, even if they can resist the freezing cold waters. So, what makes Lake Pustovi so mysterious and dangerous? Well, nothing seems to want to live here, and scientists have yet to discover why. They tried to fill the lake with many types of fish and various plant species to see if they could survive in the waters, but the results were disappointing. Since we don't know exactly what makes it so difficult to survive here, don't go running for your swimming trunks just yet. It's best if you stay away. Hey, you don't have to tell me twice.
Are you a pro swimmer? Brave enough to take a dip in any ocean or sea? Bad news. There are some places you should avoid no matter how well you swim or dive. Some of these places have dangerous underwater rocks, strong currents, and tides. Others are famous for legends about monsters and mysterious creatures. So let's dive into this aquatic horror show. Have you ever heard the word the strid? It's a variation of the word the stride that is used in Yorkshire. And it refers to a narrow section of the river wharf that's so small you could jump over it. But don't be fooled by its size, it's one of the most dangerous spots around. Even taking a step into the water can have dire consequences. The river wharf has a forceful current, and since the strid is so narrow, it's even stronger in that area. The intense water flow has eroded the limestone around the strid, which created hollow spaces much deeper than the rest of the riverbed. Here's the secret. The current has also weakened the banks of the strid from below. So, the ground you're standing on, admiring the rapid flow, is probably just a fragile ledge hanging over treacherous waters. There's no record of anyone who found themselves in the water of the strid and found their way out of it. And the worst part? You wouldn't even guess that this innocent-looking stream could be such a danger. So, my advice to you, my friend, is to stick to a safer body of water for your aquatic adventures. If you're looking for a weekend getaway in California, Horseshoe Lake is the spot for you. It's got everything. sandy beaches, hiking trails, and picnic areas, but wait, there's more to it than meets the eye. This lake has a dark side, namely around 100 acres of dead trees that surround it. And it's not just the trees that have been claimed by this lake. The earthquakes that hit in 1989 and 1990 unleashed carbon dioxide from under the hot magma. The gas seeped out into the air, damaging all the life around the lake. Even now, Horseshoe Lake is just as dangerous as it was 30 years ago. What makes it so scary is that the levels of this toxic gas change randomly. Warning signs that are posted everywhere certainly could give a horror film touch to a fun hike in the woods. In Kauai, Hawaii, there's a group of stunning waterfalls that used to be a popular destination for tourists. Kipu Falls, as they're called, were once the go-to spot for swimming and diving. To get to them, you had to take a long walk along a dirt path until you finally arrived at a breathtaking view of a 20-foot waterfall pouring into a crystal-clear pool below. But since 2011, this area has been off-limits to the public. Why, you ask? Well, there have been a lot of accidents at Kipu Falls. Obviously, jumping off the top of the waterfall would be an obvious reason for that. But in addition, there were much more mysterious cases. Witnesses tell tales of swimmers peacefully enjoying the pool at the bottom of the falls, only to be suddenly dragged under the surface. No definite explanation was found to these accidents. The locals believe that the water spirit Mo'o is to blame because it doesn't appreciate being disturbed by loud tourists. There's also a theory of a powerful whirlpool at the bottom of the pool. In any case, guide publishers do not mention Kipu Falls anymore, and trespassing is severely punished. The Samizan Hole, located in the Gulf of Thailand, is the ultimate spot for thrill-seeking divers, but it's also the most dangerous one. With a drop of 280 feet, it's the deepest diving site in the region. But its depth is not the only reason it is considered a place to avoid. The area is a major shipping zone for giant oil tankers. The strong currents around the hole make diving even more treacherous. And if that's not enough, the Samisen Hole is also home to deadly barracudas that could easily attack unsuspecting divers. The water is so murky that visibility is nearly zero, making it challenging to spot these aggressive sea creatures. All in all, the Samisen Hole is a breathtaking but extremely hazardous spot that should only be explored by experienced divers with nerves of steel. Let me tell you about New Smyrna Beach, the shark attack capital of the world. If you're looking for a relaxing vacation spot in Volusia County, Florida, you may want to reconsider this beach. The waters around New Smyrna Beach are teeming with fish, which attracts a lot of sharks. In fact, there have been so many shark attacks reported in this area that it's earned the title of the Shark Attack Capital of the World. Even scientists have warned that if you go for a swim there, you're bound to get up close and personal with at least one of these creatures. We are talking about a distance of 10 feet, and in many cases you wouldn't even notice it. To make matters worse, the bull shark, one of the most dangerous and aggressive types of sharks, has been spotted in these waters. Once again, Kauai is on our list. The beach on Nepali coast called Hanakapiai Beach might look like heaven on earth, but don't be fooled. To get there, you have to trek through a super steep, rocky 2-mile trail. There are no lifeguards on this remote beach, so even if you decide to take a dip in the water, you're on your own. The biggest threat to your safety is the incredibly strong rip currents. They are almost always present because there are no reefs to shield the shore. And if someone gets caught in one, there's no safe place to swim to for miles. The nearest safe beach is 6 miles away. Trust me, this beach doesn't have the best track record in terms of safety, so it's highly advised that you stay out of the water if you end up at this beach. Let me tell you about a place that looks like it's straight out of a horror movie. We're talking about Berkeley Pit, which is an artificial lake situated in Butte, Montana. The first thing you'll notice about this place is that it has an eerie blood-red color that can only be described as unsettling. You might be tempted to take a dip, but that would be a grave mistake. Don't even touch it. The water is extremely dangerous due to the heavy metals present in it, such as cadmium, arsenic, zinc, lead, and copper. They come from the rocks that surround the lake and make the water super acidic. In fact, this place used to be an open-pit copper mine, hence its color. So if you want my advice, avoid this place like the plague. There are three lakes in Africa that maybe are the most dangerous places of all that I have mentioned so far. They're all located in Africa. Lake Monoun and Lake Nyos in Cameroon and Lake Kivu in Rwanda are all like ticking timers ready to go off. They were formed over underground pools of molten rock, and sometimes this molten rock releases toxic gases like methane and carbon dioxide right into the water. When this happens, the gases can build up until they suddenly burst out of the water, creating massive waves that can wipe out everything in their path. This type of outburst is called a limnic eruption, and it can release a cloud of poisonous gas that can be harmful to everything in the vicinity. The most terrifying part? These explosions can happen at any moment with no warning. So if you ever find yourself near one of these lakes, you'd better be on high alert, because you never know when the next accident might happen. Maybe you know other places you wouldn't recommend for a fun swim? Share your anti-recommendations in the comments below.
Deep Dive Dubai is now the deepest pool in the world at 200 feet deep. The building on the outside resembles a giant oyster with pools and fountains, since the UAE has a deep-rooted culture for pearl diving. It may look like any regular pool on the surface, but down below, it's a marvel in engineering and planning. It's equipped with state-of-the-art gear and equipment for beginners and pros. You can either snorkel or dive the whole thing. The water is maintained at a constant temperature of 85 degrees Fahrenheit, which is ideal for diving and wearing all the gear and wetsuit. You won't have to worry about the cold temperatures typically found in oceans and seas. Each oxygen tank supplied can last anywhere between 30 to 45 minutes. Of course, a trained diver knows how to regulate each breath when swimming. The first few feet is meant for the warm-up and training, but after 100 feet below, the environment resembles a submerged city to explore, which requires some experience to embark. You can find anything from a furnished apartment building to a submerged car, which you can even sit inside. There are some interactive objects to fiddle around with, like a pool table and a chessboard. There is no marine life, since it's considered to be a swimming pool and not an aquarium. Building an aquarium would require a whole new approach to building, planning, and maintenance, which Deep Dive Dubai doesn't offer. The experience is even more surreal, knowing that there are people watching you from the outside. Anyone can sit in the restaurant and have some snacks, sandwiches, and icy cool drinks while viewing the underwater playground. The place has a gift shop to take some cool souvenirs home, and even a space to host meetings and conferences. Also, the staff will monitor you in case anything happens. Besides them observing you through the windows, there are 56 cameras installed around to make sure nothing bad happens. It's well maintained and monitored to ensure any diver's safety. The engineers built the pool in a concrete structure and installed the region's most advanced hyperbaric chamber with a capacity of 12 people for emergencies. It's also a good place for the divers to rest and catch a breath of fresh air, literally. The pool contains 3.9 million gallons of fresh water that gets filtered and circulates every 6 hours. The filtration system uses volcanic rocks and special technology developed by NASA. There are speakers from the top all the way down 50 feet, 15 to be exact. The speakers are used to create more ambiance while diving. It has underwater shutters that can close and open to make an even greater experience diving in complete darkness. But the pool has 150 lights to control the mood and atmosphere. It makes it feel like you're diving in a haunted cave. In such a case, they can provide you with a flashlight to see. In fact, after any dive, it's recommended to wait between 18 to 24 hours before going up to 1,000 feet. But there's no risk of doing the opposite. Deep Dive Dubai is equal to 6 Olympic-sized swimming pools, claiming the gold from Deep Spot in Poland. This deep pool is 150 feet deep compared to Deep Dive Dubai's 200, and is meant as a training ground for divers of all levels. This giant pool cost almost $11 million from the ground up over the course of 2 years. It used an estimated 11,000 tons of steel to build, dethroning Italy's Y40 Deep Joy, which was the deepest pool in the world. The temperature is kept at a range between 32 degrees Celsius to 34 degrees Celsius, which is also perfect for diving in a wetsuit. It has a small shipwreck for divers to discover and artificial caves in various places to explore. It feels like swimming in a submerged Mayan ruins. The pool fits 27 times the amount of a regular swimming pool and has a glass tunnel connecting one end of the room to another. There's a lot of details put into the project that are visible when walking through it. Anyone can descend down the blue hole to test their diving skills, which is at the bottom of the pool. The place even offers an underwater hotel with a view of the interior of the pool from the rooms. And just like Deep Dive Dubai, the pool doesn't feature any marine life, since it's not considered to be an aquarium. But it's open for everyone to learn the basics of diving, or for thrill-seeking experienced divers. Nemo 33 is located in Brussels, Belgium, and is also one of the deepest pools in the world. It was built in 2004 and took 7 years to complete. It cost more than $3 million from start to finish, and was designed by an engineer with diving experience. The pool uses more than 500,000 gallons of filtered spring water all the time. It's built to challenge your diving skills and even emulates the conditions of the sea and ocean. It has many simulations and obstacles to make it more fun and is perfect for beginners and pro divers. It was even used in Hollywood movies for underwater scenes. It's a great place to experience the sea without actually stepping foot inside. From the surface to the bottom is 115 feet, but you can reach depths between 15 feet and 30 feet if you want to take it easy. The pool has incredible built-in cave simulations to heighten the experience and make you want to come back for more. And just like the others, no marine life exists here as well. Time to step outside for sun in the largest pool in the world, City Stars Sharm el-Sheikh. Located in the middle of the Sinai Desert, this area is known for resorts and touristic getaways. The pool is supplied with seawater and takes weeks to fill up the million square feet worth of water. It's not easy swimming in such a pool, but it's safe and sound. The second largest outdoor pool in the world is San Alfonso del Mar in Chile. It's around 60 miles away from Santiago in a town called Algarrobo, which is a bustling tourist area. It's 20 times the size of an average Olympic pool at 3,200 feet long and more than 100 feet deep. The pool uses water from the Pacific Ocean and is constantly being pumped, filtered, and cleansed. 66 million gallons to be exact, for a volume of 860,000 square feet. The engineers that designed this pool utilized pulses and ultrasonic filtration to keep the salt water purified. It's a good system, since it doesn't require too much chlorine and electricity in the design. The pool is so big, you can literally sail from one side to another on a small sailboat or canoe. And once you anchor up, you can go to an actual sandy beach where you can enjoy the natural waves and the palm trees. Ikkyl Cenote is one of the most unique bodies of water that acts as a natural pool. Located in the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico, this place was historically important to the Mayans back then, but is now one of the most popular natural pools in the world. It was formed by a collapsing cave and created a 200-foot-wide hole that's 115 feet deep. The water is crystal clear and is perfect for relaxing and escaping the crowd of a typical pool. You can either jump in and dive into the water, or you can descend down the ladder that's been carved into the limestone wall. I'll take the former, please. The Enchanted River in the Mindanao Island in the Philippines is mysterious, yet charming, since no one knows about the creation of it. The color of the river stands out among all other rivers, ranging from aquamarine blue in the shallow regions to dark blue in the deeper ends. But in most cases, you can see the bottom of the river since the water is so clear. The river itself isn't that big to begin with and is close to the ocean. Some locals believe that this river is a home for spirits, and some areas are forbidden to swim in. But either way, this mesmerizing place is somewhere everyone should take a dip in.